you know, this is one of the most urgent moral issues and crises that we have in America right now. This is not a political issue. Children dying in detention centers should not be a partisan concern. It should be a universal concern for every American in the United States. You know, earlier this week, we were here and we were hearing inside that Capitol, the State of the Union, and the president said something. He said and spoke of the idea that he likes, quote unquote, legal immigration. But that is a lie. The president does not like any form of immigration. He has been cutting down and imposing restrictions on legal forms, on the diversity visa lottery, on family reunification, and so on. He's ending TPS. He's ending DACA protections for Dreamers. And in doing so, he is taking away the documented status of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands, of Americans. In doing so, he is criminalizing a population of people in the United States. And now he is asking for $5 billion to continue to militarize and weaponize a force that has zero accountability, that whose director and whose secretary has no idea when she goes in front of a hearing how many children are dying in her own care, under her own watch, and they have the audacity to ask for more money to fund that? I don't think so.
No.
I don't think so. Not only will we not agree to fund that, but we're here to say that an agency like ICE, which repeatedly and systematically violates human rights, does not deserve a dime.
That's right. That's
they
right.
do not deserve a dime. Until they can prove that they are honoring human rights, until they can make a good faith effort to expand and embrace immigrants, the immigrants in this nation that have always been a part and have always been and always been a core element of American democracy, until they can prove good faith to an American ideal, they do not deserve any resources for their radical agenda. We have to have respect for children, respect for families, respect for human rights, and respect for the right of human mobility.